We recognize these signs, of course. Here in Columbus, police look at about 300 potential traffic violations caught by red light cameras each and every day. They say the cameras are like having extra police out on the street. But opponents, on the other side, they believe the state Supreme Court will ultimately find them unconstitutional.
I don't think it makes me any better of a driver.
Lindsay Speed got a traffic ticket in the mail after she says she was going the speed limit through an intersection when the light was yellow.
Yes, I may have been going through the red light, but you know when it's like it's turning yellow and you don't really have, you know, a lot of control if you're already going a certain speed.
Her dislike of the red light cameras is shared by nearly 30 state lawmakers and civil liberties groups.
The Ohio Supreme Court has actually ruled against cities' arguments just like this. Over and over again.
Columbus attorney Maurice Thompson has filed a brief with the Ohio Supreme Court against the cameras. He says they're unconstitutional and just cash machines for cities. He wants the high court to ban them statewide and refund past tickets.
It's an illegal fine. It's an illegal assessment. They should have to pay it back.
Columbus police see the red light cameras very differently. They point to video that shows time and time and time again, drivers are running red lights, endangering everyone around them.
When I look at the stats on the city of Columbus, some of our intersections, the accidents have gone down 100%.
Lieutenant Brent Maul with Columbus Police says the results speak for themselves, and he views each camera as just another officer on the street.
The officer is really that camera. You're facing your accuser right there.
Lindsay Speed disagrees. She paid her fine, but says a camera does not substitute for a real officer.
I think if I would have been able to have a conversation, I probably would have been able to get out of it.